Good morning, my dear students. This is Dr. J. Jayshankar, head of the Department of Commerce. You are participating in a webinar this morning. The theme of the webinar is Looming Progressions and Practicality of Audit in Corporate Sector, Finance and Accounts. Our resource person this morning is Mr. Fazil Shakir. He is a BBM CMA. Mr. Fazil Shakir did his BBM degree course in Gurnana College, Chennai, and he is also a certified management accountant. He secured All India 24th rank in the CMA course, and he worked as a proctor with Eon CoCubes, a hiring firm. Then he was also an articled associate, and he worked in a casting firm in Chennai for some time. And he also worked with IndiaFilings.com as an associate, and worked with ITC Limited. He is currently placed in Bihar. I have immense pleasure in welcoming Mr. Fazil Shakir on your behalf and on behalf of the Postgraduate and Research Department of Commerce. The topic for today's discussion is Looming Progressions and Practicality of Audit in Corporate Sector, Finance and Accounts. You all study auditing this semester, my dear students, and you all know very well that auditing starts where accounting ends. So the process of auditing will start only after the accounts have been prepared. Accounting is mainly external reporting. The accountants will prepare the final accounts, profit and loss account and balance sheet. The profit and loss account, you all know, discloses profit or loss made by the firm or company. And balance sheet reveals the financial position of the company. And the job of the auditor, who must be a qualified chartered accountant under the Companies Act. Only a qualified chartered accountant can do the job of auditing. So he has to verify the accounts that have been prepared by the accountants. An accountant need not be a CA, a chartered accountant, but the auditor has to be a chartered accountant. So he will verify all the accounts, the profit and loss account, and will state that the profit shown by the profit and loss account is true. And he also has to certify that the financial position revealed by the balance sheet is correct. And you are all familiar with most of the auditing concepts like internal check, internal control, vouching, verification, and so on. So I think today's discussion will focus on these concepts, and Mr. Fazil Shakir will also share with you as to what has happened in recent times in the field of auditing. Is auditing today the same as what it was 20 years back, 30 years back? Now, technology plays a crucial role in every sphere of activity. So auditing cannot be an exception to it. Technology does play a crucial part even in the job of an auditor. So with these few introductory remarks, I am happy to hand over the session to our guest speaker, Mr. Fazil Shakir. Over to Mr. Fazil Shakir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Good morning, everyone. Before introducing about myself, hope you, your family members, your loved ones, and everyone is safe and secure in an environment now. Before starting about the course itself, I would like to discuss and get into few things. First one is, think about a phone call back 20 years ago. We used to have this trunk phone those days, right? Madam and sir would have seen the trunk phone, yet we would have not seen. Those trunk phones and also the ambassador cars. Those days we used to have those ambassador cars there. It was very difficult in a trunk call to get connected. And it was like a prepaid. You have to go to a district office or a post office and then connect to those calls. And it takes huge number of time and effort to do those things, right? You have to go to a physical location, then request those people and then make a phone call. and it is like for 1 minute or 2 minutes, then it will automatically end. Before that, you have to recharge it, right? So times were so difficult back then. And about this ambassador car, with all due respect, those cars often were not so fast or were not so comfortable to sit, and it gets breakdown. Times were different then, 20 years back. And just shift now the current scenario here. You have fast cars which are comfortable, which never gets breakdown too often. And then about the phones, you all have smartphones, geo connected networks, 4G's, so that we can do the video calls and things. The same way as this technology changes, everything around you and yourself also changes. 20 years ago, your parents had so much difficulties in doing work. Work means your professional works, correct? So in those days, to do a job in a timely manner, in a perfect manner, and also in a manner which is correct, that will easily get recognized and appreciated by the immediate supervisor or the employer, correct? Because those things are considered back then. I want this session to be interactive, so that whenever I ask a question, if you can in chat reply or say that yes, agreed or disagree, even if you don't disagree, that is fine. So that do you agree to this? 20 years ago, things were different and very difficult to do, correct? Okay, I'm not getting any replies here. Fine. So I think everybody has agreed to it. So during those days, by doing your job correct, right, and on a timely manner, you get recognized. You get recognized in the sense you get promoted and you get the things done. Come back here 20 years after now, because you are third year students, next year you are going into the job market, right? You'll be employed somewhere else or the other. So at present, if you're going to get into a job, you have these fast computers, laptops, and ready data available. Data analytics tools are there. And on the go, data and things will be done. In that case, by just doing your job correct on a timely manner, do you think you will get recognized? You will never get recognized. And the main thing is that there are dozens and dozens of people like us or people like you who are going to do their job correct on a routine manner. So this will not help you to get yourself equipped or promoted or get noticed from your immediate boss or employer. Routine things can be done by anyone, right? By machines also. You have to get to that extra mile when you do your job and cannot be replaced by someone else or something else. It should be unique, just like the content creators or anything else. The finance job is also something like that. It has shifted. Even the audit, finance or corporate accounts, everything has shifted from a basic thing that you have to follow this provisions of the income tax, this GST compliance, TDS, TCS, that has been shifted. By doing a routine job, you will not be able to get what you expect, right? So you have to do something which is out of the box or which is unique and which can be done only by you, right? Think of it, have the patience, and in the end of the session, suggest me that what else the unique way you can think or unique way you can do that can make your employer or the person think that this job can be done by you only. So think of it. I will come to this thing later. Now coming back, hi, this is Fazil. You can just call me Fazil. I basically graduated from Guru Nanak College, did my BCom Bank Management, 2018 passed out. And also did my CMA from Institute of Cost and Management Accountants of India. And eventually I am also rank holder, rank 24. So I have this beautiful connect, but small connect with DG Vaishnav College. After completing my schooling, I tried to join DG Vaishnav College those days in the first shift, but unfortunately my marks weren't up to the standard of the college, so I didn't get seat. Then, but this journey has been good in 3 years, because I know that you people have known this Pragati competition and intercollegiate, which is conducted by DG every year on year. So I have attended all those functions, intercollegiate, and won many accolades there. So I know where DG is, where is the department, where is the this auditorium, and I have a basic understanding of how DG Vaishnav College works and how students are. So it's very, I'm very happy, excited, at the time very nervous, because I always think that the next batch which comes outside is always equipped than the batch which has gone 2 years or 3 years back. So I know you are more equipped than me, more knowledgeable than me. So taking a session to you requires a hell of a lot of preparations and things, so that I can give something which you don't know and which will be helpful for you in the future to come or in the job market. Correct. So let's get into this. And before that, I have to thank Dr. Premalata Madam for giving this opportunity to interact with students, which I like very much, and also being patient with me. I had a lot of phone calls, doubts, clarity on what should I do, because Madam would have already taught auditing and things, everything in a very better manner than me. So thinking about that, what extra things I can do. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Fazil.
And also my sincere thanks to Dr. Jay Shankar sir, head of the department, commerce shift 1, and head of the department shift 2, S. Sheshadri Nathan sir, for giving this opportunity, and also the DG Vaishnav College management postgraduate and research development department of commerce as a whole, and sincere thanks to students who have logged in to hear this session. Thank you so much. In the working part that I will share, that I will start within few minutes. So basically, before that, I would like to brief up on the things I would say, so that you will get an idea of where I am coming from, so that you can link with what I am going to say. Correct. So after college and qualification, I joined Aon CoCubes as a proctor. Proctor is that simply going to the examination centers and conducting tests. That is a very simple job. Then also with reputed cost audit firms as associate, then joined indiafilings.com, which is a pioneer in income tax filing in India. Then in campus, got placed with ITC Limited. ITC Limited is one of the top 3 FMCG manufacturers in India, top 10 company by market share in India, around 60,000 crores. It has market share of 60,000 crores in India. So it produces few well-known brands like you would have seen Engage Perfumes, Bingo, Hippie, ITC Hotels like Chola, ITC Chola and Gindi, Royal Bengal, and many more hotels. Candyman, Be Natural, Savlon, Ashirwad, every FMCG as a whole. So I work as finance superintendent in a unit which manufactures these things as a finance resource, as a finance manager. So now into the topics. First thing first, I don't want to waste your 40 minutes by boring lecturers, and like which will add zero value to you. So I want this session to be interactive and in a way that I want to share things. At the same time, I want to share things which you people want. So if you have any specific queries or specific things which you need to understand or you need to know, you can just comment in the chat box. I don't know either in this chat private message is available. If you don't want to ask questions which is like you want to be anonymous, you can also private chat. I don't know whether Google Meet gives that option. So I want this session to be interactive first, so please ask questions to me so that I can answer. So before starting, I will start with something like this. I personally feel that you are updated, upgraded, and up to date to the curriculum, to the audit and everything, because I personally feel whoever comes qualifies late will have a better idea of things. So it's all about this thing, right? Definition of auditing, forensic audit, opportunity of auditors, ISA, benefits of audits, IT related audits, and in exam perspective, 3-mark question, 15-mark question, 10-mark question. So this things you know very well than me, because you have recently studied and your resource persons have like ample knowledge, ocean of knowledge which you can mine and extract from them. Google is there, so everything is there for that. So my question is, why do you study all these in the first place, in college or school? I mean, why you study audit? Being a finance guy, you should know why you studied audit, right? So please answer. Why you study this topic in college, in finance? Or normally, why you study anything? To get a knowledge about auditing and analyzing. I am asking, why you study audit? I know by studying audit, you will get the knowledge and things, right? My question is something else. Why you study audit, not what you learn from studying audit? Puducherry, sir, that's why. Because it's in your syllabus, right? Even if you don't like it, it's in syllabus, you have to study. So all you do is for the knowledge and improvement of one's quality of life. This is where I left things. So now, looming progression and practicality of audit in corporate sector, finance and accounts. Correct. The basics of audit is the audit definition says that auditing can be defined as inspecting, comparing, checking, reviewing, vouchering, ascertaining, scrutinizing, examining, transaction, recording, bookkeeping, and then accounting. Then comes the audit part, right? So it is a process which envisages the documents and so on. And the person who does this thing is called as an auditor. So auditing basically covers, in my perspective, auditing covers accounting also, because you are auditing the accounts which has been prepared by someone else. So it covers accounting, internal control systems, review mechanisms, examinations of books, examination of records and documents, compliance with your SOP. SOP means the standard operating procedure in a company. Audit needs base, right? Audit is the reporting of deviation which should not happen. So the standard is already fixed
So this is deviating from the standard. That is called your SOP, standard operating procedure. This thing should be done in this way only. Your assets should be capitalized in this date. Asset value should be this. Your revenue recognition principle should be this. If that is not being followed, then it is not according to your SOP. And reporting of that thing, everything together is covered in auditing. Objectives of auditing: to check and determine whether the statement is true or not. That is the basic definition. And then the second one will be to report errors, if any, or to report fraud, if any. There are two objectives, right? The primary objective and the secondary objective. Secondary objective may or may not be there. The primary objective will always be there, that we have to check and say whether this is true or not. And the second one will be reporting if it is not true, what are the deviation which has been there. When coming to principles of audits: integrity, confidentiality. Confidentiality in this sense means you have audited a company or a part of company, so you cannot discuss about that to anyone else other than where you are reporting. Even the company has made a fraud or has done something else, you cannot verbally or tell to someone or somebody else that this thing has happened. That is against the principles of auditing. You are appointed as an auditor by someone else. You should report to the concerned person with for documentations only. You cannot blatantly say or disclose any information. Next one is skill and competency. Skill means the ability to perform an audit. Competency means the qualification to perform an audit. You will have all necessary skills to perform an audit, but you may not be qualified. You may be qualified, but you won't have the skills to perform an audit. So skills and competence both required. Then comes the documentation part of the audit. So you have to basically collect all information, document it, then planning of audits, audit evidences, accounting systems and internal controls, and finally the conclusion of an audit physically. Then it takes normally 15 to 20 days to actually prepare a report, to submit it and get the final audited statement right. What are the audits or why audits? There are actually three different sections if you take it practically. One is legal point, compliance. For few, audit is compulsory, like statutory audits, cost audits, secretarial audit. These are audits which are compulsory under an act of a government or by government itself. Income Tax Act 1961 says the audit should be necessary, tax audit should be done. Because of that compliance, you are auditing things, right? It is not mandate. It is not like that you voluntarily go and do an audit. It is that some rules and regulations are there, audit should be done. So for that purpose, you are doing the audit. Tax audit, GST audit. GST audit has not practically started yet because there is delays and deadlines going on. Insurance claims. For insurance getting claims, you have to mandatory get audited. Then internal control audits. For Cook and discovery of errors at the first time itself, and moral check audit of employees, whether the policies are being followed. Uniformity in accounts. Audit are done for the purpose of uniformity in accounts, that everything is accounted in the same manner or similar manner, no deviation from it. Then external affairs audit. External affairs audit before mergers and acquisitions, valuation of assets and goodwills. In terms of settlements, these audits are performed. These are the broad types of audits which are performed in case of the scenarios, the requirement. One is legal, one is internal you do for yourself for better control over the company and better control over the processes, and the external affairs for which audit has been done. Types of audit includes statutory audits, cost audit, tax audit, secretarial audit, special statutory audits, internal audits. And the other things are like, one by one, the audit evidence, reliability and methods, procedure or test of controls, concept of materiality, whether the audit evidence or the audit which you have been doing. For example, in practical scenario, if 50,000 has been reported at 5,000 and the materiality is 45,000 only, correct? It won't be that much materialistic in a company which has a turnover of more than 50,000 crores. So where materiality comes, these points will be dropped or these points are not material enough to be kept, correct? Then you have this planning and performance of audit, advantages and disadvantages of audits, information system audits, audit planning program and procedure, how to conduct an audit, how to start an audit, how to end an audit, correct? And things like audit working papers, which are basic documents on which audit has been done, audit notebooks, which is an extinct thing. Audit notebooks you will read in syllabus and read in books, but now audit notebook is not a physical notebook or something like that. It may be an Excel sheet in which you have preferred what are the things to be done, like questionnaire, audit questionnaire. These things you will ask the auditor and you will do this, correct? Then quality control of audit work papers, audit samplings, internal controls, internal checks, and internal audit, correct? What is internal control and what is internal check and what is internal audit? Can anyone text what are the differences between this? Internal, because this is the basics, this is something not related to auditing, but these are the basics of auditing. Internal control, internal checks, and internal audit. Why? Because tax audit, cost audit, and secretarial audit, these audits are done by professionals who are CAs, CMAs, CS. Those people do these audits. But internal audit can be done by anyone, internal audit and management audit. There is no such qualification that he should be qualified as a chartered accountant or cost accountant. So this area has huge scope for BCom graduates. If you have the strong hold on internal audit. So for that reason, I am stressing on this. Key, what are the differences or what are the things which are there in internal control, internal check, and internal audit? Anyone can unmute and say or even text, what is that? The differences or what you understand from these three words. Because this is very important. No, this is something you are going to do after graduation. If you get into any of the big four companies or for that matter, any other firms, if you are getting into an audit, you will do this only, internal audits. Okay, fine. Internal controls means the established system which is already present, the procedures, After bookkeeping will be done by this clerk, accounting will be done by this associate, and final review will be done by the manager. This is the process. So this is the internal control. An internal check is that the interlink between these things. After doing this transaction, this will not involve a particular person. It involves two person, that this person will check that one, and the manager will finally check all the things. This is internal check. Internal audit is postmortem of these things. Internal audit is a separate thing. There will be an internal auditor. After accounting and that, for that instance, after that financial year is completed, somebody else will completely check the all processes. That is called internal audit. This is the difference between these three, and you people will be part of the internal audit team if you get into audit related jobs. You people will be doing the internal audit, so this is necessary to be understood. In this framework, I have said the basics of everything which I wanted to say, or I wanted to explain to you, correct? So is that any specific thing which you need to further elaborate? If you can ask, or ma'am, can you say, ma'am, ki this particular thing these people are interested, or these people will be willing to know, so that in that I can spend a few minutes, ma'am.
Can you repeat the question, Fazil?
Ma'am, these are like have completed till the internal audit control and systems. So in that, which is more relevant to students, so that I can spend few minutes on this, like which is the topic which will be more relevant to them or more interesting, or the students want to know more about it, so that we can spend few minutes about the practically how those things are done, so that it will be useful.
You would like to whatever you would like to communicate, you just inform them. They are all very interested to learn many things. Okay.
So after that, so I hope these things have been covered well. And so next, going to that, voucher and verification. Vouchering and verification, letter of engagement, reporting, audit guidelines. Audit guidelines are nothing but a set of guidelines. Maybe it can be SCA or accounting guidelines which are issued by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India for audit related to taxation, or Cost Accountants of India for management audits. That are the guidelines which are bare acts, or the standard things which have to be checked like that. So letter of engagement is given by the company itself to perform an audit. For example, I'm not going into the secretarial thing, or tax audit or cost audit knowingly, because those areas are not practically there to be explored, or like there is no scope for graduates to do in this area. Whether you will be there as an article associate to get the things done, or because those things are done by a separate professional, which is not relevant. So I'm again getting into the management system audits, correct? So I will briefly explain about how a company works in few minutes. Before that, I would say that internal audit team gets a letter from the company to audit this particular unit, or this particular division, or this particular finance portion. That is called audit engagement. In this, it will be written that the audit should be completed from this period to this period, and these will be the audit managers, and these are the access will be provided to them. They can audit these things, so that the set of guidelines and what they should do and what are the limitations will already be established, and they will start the audit, right? Internal audit of a unit or of a factory takes around 3 to 4 months minimum. to get completed. Around 3 to 4 people come and they will be there for around 3 months to know the entire process and entire system and then to complete an audit. After that, they will give the report and there will be negotiations and thing. It will again take 2 months. So it takes 6 months, around 6 months to do an internal audit, thorough internal audit. And internal audits are done mostly 3 years once or 4 year once, depending upon the unit. Divisional audit are done every year. Divisional audit is the division itself audits its own financials and things. That will be completed in 1 week or so. So that is done every year. These are the different types of audit in a factory. Internal audit means divisional audit can be done or corporate audit can be done, right? So in this time frame, I have said these many things. So to know a better understanding of this, the better thing is to go through your syllabuses and books, and ma'ams will have a better understanding and concept knowledge of these things. Now, coming back to the things I have mentioned earlier, I mentioned earlier that you get knowledge by just not reading books and things. You have to physically get into this audit structures and reporting and stuff. So have anybody gone through any of the financials which are issued by the companies? You are studying internal audit in your this thing, right? Paper audit and these things. Have anybody gone through an audit report or a financial statement which is available in any website of the company? Companies normally post financial statements in their websites. They have to post. So have anyone gone through this? Basically, what is there in a financial statement? What are the things which a board of director conveys in his letter? There is a separate thing called a comment of board of directors in which he mentions about the company and things. So have anyone gone through that? Those are the main things which you have to learn, or you have to have the habit or inculcate to get better in the field of finance or commerce, whatever you are going to do. So have anybody gone through it? Right, fine. So what I say is that okay, how you get, okay, somebody has messaged, yes, sir. So he has messaged, yes, sir. So what you have gone through in that? So what I actually want to is when a resource person comes, because now things are changing, right? Resource person, actually we come in Skype or something like that, and instead of we giving lectures or things on something, if you are interested on something or you can ask, because some knowledge, I don't say that I have entire knowledge of things, but I have some knowledge and practical exposures that I can share with you. For that you have to ask something. You should ask me questions so that you can mine the knowledge or mine the things which I have and get the stuff out from me, right? For that purpose, I am requesting you. Because we people used to do these things. We keep on asking questions, random questions, even if it is not relevant. Okay, fine. Nobody is asking any questions. Right, fine. So, practical audits. Have come into this thing. So ma'am asked me to just brief through what is audit, because she wanted people to understand the practical side of how a company works and how things are done. So I will take time in that, because ma'am has said that that is more relevant to them, because they have to get the exposure of how a company works and how things are done differently in different companies, so that they will get an exposure of how things work when they complete their college, and how they have to get place, or what knowledge or what skill sets they have to possess to get into good companies, and what they people require. So when you think about audit, everybody thinks about the big four, right? Deloitte, KPMG, PwC and EY-GDS. These are the big four auditing firms which have. But I would say that it is not just auditing firms. is accounting and auditing services, including external audits and other tax related audits, management of financials, business consultancy, and assurance. These people do these many things. They are not just audit firms. They are not audit firms. They are a package of things which they provide to the customers. Correct. In this post-COVID scenario, internal audit is very a small portion of that. In the post-COVID scenario, what these people are trying is that to minimize the physical presence in an audit and to involve digital and artificial means to do these things and eliminate the resources, correct? So most importantly, they are working into the data analytics. For example, I have a task, correct? I have a task to check between difference in a particular note in a financial asset register. Asset register is there, and here is a thing which you audited in Excel. So we have to match this, right? That is internal audit. If it doesn't match, we will report. These things normally people do, but they are trying to automate these things by an AI tool which automatically plots and will give an answer readily that this doesn't match here, correct? So you will have this question that after I graduate and if I get a job in a big four, things, what is the thing you will be doing, right? So the first thing you will be doing is you will be supporting the internal audit team. They will be in the client side, mostly offshores. The team will be offshores and they will send data to you. The data will be, you will have to do the basic matching and okay, with the actuals. They will send a report which will contain what the actuals are, and you will already have a report which is shared by the client. These are the things. So you will basically match and report. These are the works which are done in Big Four when you start as an entry level associate. After graduation, you will be taken as an entry level associate in Big Four firms. So this type of works you will be doing, correct? So I need to give a brief on that. So I have done. So these are the works you will be doing when you get into an audit related job. And coming to other things, which as an internal audit, there are two different things. First one, I have said that if you get into EY for Big Four, you will be doing audit for somebody else, right? Somebody else will be on offshore and it will be a client. These people deal with client. And if you are getting into a company, the audit is totally different, right? In a company, you work as an employee. You will be working in the finance team or you will be working in some other team. There will be a separate audit team. There will be a separate audit team which will be auditing your reports. For example, you are placed in an audit team, right? So what will be you doing? First, finance control checklist. Every month, finance does a routine of activities, right? These routine of activities will be audited on a month-on-month basis. That is one thing which you for that. Let me explain how finance works, correct? How a factory works. Anybody interested to know how actually a factory hierarchy and how factories work? Okay. See. There is a corporate. Corporate is like a head office, in which consolidation, corporate treasury, corporate accounts, corporate internal audit. I mentioned corporate internal audit. These teams work. After that comes the divisions. divisions or different business divisions. For example, EA is a company which produces products like, for example, biscuit, juice, shoes. These three are different divisions. These three will report to corporate. This is head division, correct? So first thing is that, so this is called divisional head office. Three different divisions are there. These people report to corporate. Corporate will have its own finance team, own production team, own engineering team. Corporate treasury will be there, things like that. And these divisions are specifically have the knowledge about their divisions only. It has an HO, and now there will be four other manufacturing plants in all three divisions, 4, 5, 6, something like that. So these people actually produce, correct, in the unit. There is a setup, manufacturing setup, in which products are being made. So here you have a finance team to look after or to administrate the setup, and you will have a production team which does all production, and there will be an engineering team which provides all technical supports, services supports. For example, if the company works on renewable energy, electricity or boilers, these supports will be given by an engineering team, and there will be an HR team, correct? Human resource team. Human resource team is very necessary, because in a unit you have around 1,000 people working. 1,000 employees will be there working, and only few managers will be there. Around 40 managers will be there to entirely manage the setup of 1,000, 1,500 people who are actually working and getting the product done. So there will be an HR team, unit HR team. There will be a head of this unit. He will be called as a unit head. This is the setup of a company, and there will be information system team to provide all IT supports. Correct. I have come from the down bottom. Now you have understood how a factory works. This factory will be reporting to its own division, which is placed somewhere. For example, Chennai. There is a plant in Sriperumbudur. Correct. Which I have explained everything. So this will be reporting to its divisional head office in Chennai, Paris, Central Broadway, which you know. So like this, there will be three divisions. One will be operating from Hyderabad, and one will be operating from Mumbai. Three divisional head offices. These head offices will consolidate their own financials and things. And in Delhi, there will be an only corporate office, from where all instructions, planning, what is the sales target, how we will improve things, new product development, research, everything will be done from there. This is how a corporate structure works in many of the companies, in many of the MNCs, right? So if you are in a corporate, I said there will be an internal audit team. So what they will do is, corporate will instruct a team to audit any of the factories or any of the HO. They will say, go to the head office of shoes division and audit. Or else they will say, go to the unit where shoes are made and audit. Correct. These things will happen. And if they get a point, that will definitely affect that division. So there will be in division a divisional audit team. This team will, in every year, there will review and audit things here. And there will be in unit, because these people report to the division, these people have to clearly maintain their books and everything. I am saying audit does not only pertain to those CS doing audit. That is a very different thing. That is, there is a scope. That is, I will not touch things. But audit can be done on production, engineering, information system. All these things can be done. On all these things can be done by business professionals like you and me, right? Commerce graduate. So the division team will also have an audit team, and you are in unit. You are being a finance guy, you will audit these departments also. You will go and audit finance itself, you will audit you will audit other divisions like production and engineering, correct? These things are in audit. In that, what you will do, first thing is that you will do the finance control checklist. What are the accounting transactions which has happened in this month, the sales, whether it is matching with the actuals. Take the SAP dump systems. Company works on SAP or Oracle, right? You have to have any of these two knowledges. Most of the companies, big companies, works on SAP or Oracle system. So you will take the dump from there. You will check whether all entries have been correctly posted or correctly parked. Then you will see the inventory. You will physically go visit the shipping, the logistics, the raw material division, and take a physical count verification. This has to happen every month. You will physically go and check and report that everything is true and fair. That whatever consumption has been made, whatever the production has been made is correct, right? Because on that basis, you file your GST, you file your IT returns, and then yourself, everything is fine, but you have made the mistakes. Instead of deducting TDS at 10%, you are deducted TDS at 2%. So that audit you will have to do. Valuation audit, you will bring an external examiner. You are going to send a machine from A Bihar to B Pune. So for that, you have to take insurance. You have to take the assurance. You have to evaluate the asset. Then for that, you have to get in touch with an assurance agency and insurance agency. For that, you have to do the audits. IT asset audit. Because IT asset audit, I will brief in that, because everything you do is related to internet, right? Whether the security is correct, whether the data is not leaking, everything is intact. So that comes as an IT related audit. Systems audit, whether everything is in place. In this COVID scenario, you have to do COVID audits. Everybody is wearing mask or not. What is the protocols? Are we following the government protocols when people enter? Are we checking temperatures? These things. These are things which are newly come, COVID related audits. These things are the different types of audit which you people can do if you get into any of the big fours. COVID audit, someone has questioned COVID related audits. Yes, COVID related audits. See, you resource is coming to factory, right? In this cases, your human resource is coming to factory and you have to ensure their safety and things. So government has issued so many protocols that these many things has to be there in a factory, and you have to ensure that, right? Everything is going on time. For example, if I have to initiate whether people are wearing masks, if the temperature is correct, then it has to. These are COVID related audits which has to be done and which will be done by mostly finance people only, because finance team is like a controlling team. So we have to do those audits, correct? These are the types of audits. And coming back, these are the different segments which I have said, and market opportunities and job opportunities currently available in this segment. See, to be honest, due to this COVID scenarios, nobody is able to predict or think what will be the job opportunities in future or things like that. Nothing is stable at the time right now. So if you have any queries, what kind of skills you have to upgrade yourself or you have to update, that you can ask in the comment. But as far as me, I'm concerned, you learn from morning to evening, right? For example, if you are in morning shift, you come at 7 o'clock and go home at 1 p.m. And if you are at evening shift, you start the college by 2 and end by 7. So what employers actually need is two things, charisma and skills. Skills will be useful when you get into a company. To get into a company, you need charisma to actually do things. So I would recommend personally, or everybody recommends personally, in a corporate, that when we hire people, because I've already been as an trainer or CoCube proctor, what we see is when a fresh graduate comes, we see whether he has some experience. You would see memes on that, ki fresher, how will fresher have an experience, right? So it is this experience that when you are in college, you have so much time to get into an audit firm or banking firm to work there for 3 to 4 hours and get the experience which is related, which can be presented in your resume when you get into the job market. That thing is always seen when people hire you. So I would recommend that you go, you get a practical exposure of things, so that when somebody asks questions or interviews, you would already know or already have an exposure to things which you have learned practically. So that thing people see first. That is the major thing which people see. And second one is communication skills. The ability to communicate what you want to communicate. This skills basically everybody has to inculcate, but that is very easy to inculcate. So that you people will definitely have, that is not an issue. But the experience which you people should have in the field, for example, after completing BCom, if some audit firm or some company comes to interview you, they want to have a set of things which is required. So that skills you need to have. So if there is any query related to that, you can question or you can chat or you can unmute, because my time of 10, ma'am has given only time for me till 10 o'clock and it is already 10. But I think, ma'am, can we extend 10 minutes, because people will have some queries or doubts related to that.
Okay, okay, you carry on. We have a sufficient time, you carry on.
So you have any queries related to what you should do? Because this session I agreed, or ma'am also wanted to take this session, not just because we have to do on auditing. Auditing was secondary for me to take a session. The session was itself designed in such a way that you people ask questions to us, that what you people feel and what is the things you need to get ready when you get into a job market, because all of them are third year, right? So what are the skills you want to develop, or what way you can improve yourself? So for that, please, you have to be open. You have to speak something or text something or unmute something. Only ma'am is there. Ma'am actually wants you to speak. She said that don't worry that ma'am will say something or that. Ma'am actually wants you people to ask questions if you want to be interactive. So you can ask questions. Hello.
Yes, students, have any queries relevant to our subject, or what you want to know about the subject in a practical way? See, I arranged this question only to get a knowledge about the practical exposure. The student should get the practical exposure about the auditing. What you are studying in a theory and what you are getting in a, what they are, what is happening in real.
See, I will give a classic example. Before 10 years, you would have all gone to this Excel coaching centers, right? Like CSE and these things. After 10 years, see, now they have disappeared. People like Udemy and Unacademy has come. So everything within a span of time disappears now in this session. You have to update yourself, upgrade yourself, and have ample knowledge to get into the job market. By being silent, I know most of the people will be having their own set of ideas or own set of maybe family owned businesses, that is fine. But somebody who has to get into the job market and search for job, you have to ask questions, or you have to able to, or you have to have the guts or thing to publicly ask questions, which will be very useful. For that purpose, I'm holding this session now, and I'm waiting that somebody will ask.
One student raised a question in a chat box. Can you see? Or can I, shall I read?
Is there any need to complain? Is there any need to complaints of costing reports, sir? See, complaints, yes, complaints is there. There are two sectors, recognized sector and unrecognized sector in the cost audit report. See, if the your industry comes under the schedules, there are so guidelines, so many guidelines. I am not actually have an idea about 25 crores or more. If it is there, then the cost audit is mandatory. If something is mandatory for an industry and it has to be done, there is no other option. So cost audit is mandatory, and for that you have to be a qualified cost management accountant to do those audits. Sir, last 4 to 5 months there is no business behavior heavily, and the portion of member workable now is less. And how will the auditors do the audit, and the period for audit will be extended or not, sir? See, this is a very good question. Nowadays, the audit has not, period has not been extended, but the virtual audit has come. For example, yesterday we have conducted an people conducted audit on us through this medium of Zoom calls, and data, we have to share the ready data, the Excel sheets and the Word files, and they will connect to Zoom and physically verify things. So audit has not stopped. Audit has been happening, and everything is for the major purpose of things. The routine jobs may have been hold due to 4 to 5 months, but all jobs are happening. As far as I am concerned, we daily go to work, audit reports and everything has been done on time, so there is no delay or no such hold, or nothing has been extended. The way of medium of communication has been changed. Physically we used to go book tickets and go to the physical place and do audits. Now it has been changed, the audit has been changed to a virtual audits. And we do audit from a distance location, but audit is happening. So nobody is asking about what are the skills which is needed to do an audit. So basically you have to have the Excel skills. Without Excel, you have to be the best in Excel. Without Excel, auditing is very difficult, because the physical part of audit is done by someone else, or the managers, they will do the audit. The audit report and things, they will be doing that. The work we, when you go on an associate level, the major thing you will be doing is an Excel report, Excel analysis, whether everything is matching, the VLOOKUP function, the conditional formatting, the duplicates, the entries, these things you will be preferring. So you need to have the Excel skills, which is very much necessary if you are going to get into this field. In audit, Excel skills and use of subject related softwares, like there will be many utilities which are not Excel utilities, and there will be, you need to have good knowledge of SAP, Oracle, depending upon the company you work. That skills or that thing, have a basic knowledge of it, so that when people ask about what is Oracle, what is SAP, what is SQL, you will know the basics, this is SQL. So you have to have that understanding. And you can actually enroll to courses from Coursera or just Udemy, which is online platform which charges free or minimal amount, so that you can upgrade the skills. By the time this pandemic ends, you will be having 2-3 other skills which will actually help. Because in interviews, I think, I personally think, or I personally believe, that when you go for an interview now after college, these people are definitely gonna ask, what did you do in this COVID times? This will be a question. Is there any certification courses you have completed during that time? Have you upgraded your skills? This will be a very common question. So you have to upgrade those skills for the purpose of job or for improving yourself. Yes, have updated. Great. So I think the questions are only that much, right?
Students, you have any more queries? Vasil, shall we conclude the session?
Yeah, sure.
Formally, we conclude the session by telling the vote of thanks. Happy morning to all. First, I would like to thank our secretary, Sri Ashok Kumar Mundraji, and principal, Dr. R. Ganesan, sir, for tremendous support in all our initiatives. I would like to convey my thanks to Dr. J. Jayashankar, sir, Ed, Department of Commerce, and Professor S. Seshadri Nadan, sir, Head Department of Commerce, Shift 2, for providing me the great opportunity to organize this webinar. On behalf of the organizing committee, I thank our key speaker of this day, Mr. Fazil Shakir, who spared the time from his busy schedule and glorified this webinar with an extremely relevant address of the theme auditing in a very practical way. Thank you, Fazil. Finally, I convey my special thanks to our students for mentorial participation. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, everyone, for giving this wonderful session and being cooperative. And if you have any queries, you can ask to madam, and she can consolidate. Then I will reply to ma'am. Or if you can ask questions anonymously, you can also mail to me, or you can ask me in Insta handle. So thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you, students. Thank you, professors.
Thank you, Fazil. Thank you for your concern. Thank you.
Okay.